This is North Star Aurora, and this glass typifies the class of North Star colors, which I refer to as the oxidizing and reducing colors. Please note the very intense high oxygen content flame with which I'm working this right now. This is called an oxidizing flame, and the way that you can tell it's oxidizing, it's a very deep blue. It's not the aqua blue that you have with a high gas flame. It's a very blue, and it's got a very loud hissing sound. This tells you that you're working with an oxidizing flame. And with these colors, if you work them with an oxidizing flame, you get a much deeper, richer, darker shade of colors. When we do another set of these legs with the same color, Aurora, with a reducing flame, you'll find a very different look. But you see, it's necessary to work this in a very, very hard, very oxidizing flame. You do have to be careful not to bubble the glass, because the high oxygen content has a tendency to heat the glass so much that it bubbles. You'll also realize, or you also know, or notice, or find out, or discover, you'll figure out that by working the glass farther out in the flame, as I'm not doing right now, it's more of an oxidizing flame because more of the gas has been combusted. This is a very important characteristic of borosilicate colors, is that they can be changed very dramatically by the type of chemistry that you're using in your flame. As the glass cools, take a good look at the color of the legs. You can see there's no color except for the dark, almost black look. This is a very, very dark brown color in appearance before you've worked with it. And if you work it with a very oxidizing flame, you can see it changes color very little at all. Nice legs. Now we're going to make a second pair of legs out of the very same rod. Please look at the difference in the flame. I've just changed this to a very soft or a reducing flame with a very high gas content. The sound is much less hissy. No hissy fits here. This sound is much more of a softer, gentler, this is a kinder, gentler flame. While the glass is still hot, you can't yet see the color differentiation which has taken place. But as the first mass cools, you begin to see that instead of a dark, deep, rich color, we have a very opaque, a very surface color. Much more in the pink and puce family than the dark, rich browns that we had in the oxidizing flame. Now I'm comparing the two legs made from the very same piece of North Star Aurora rod. Look at the difference when you use a reducing flame and an oxidizing flame. The one on the right was highly oxidized, the one on the left is highly reduced. Which one will you choose? Which will you pick? Which one would you like to take home to your mother?